course, is absolutely right that the First Minister and my party should be engaging with the Loyalist Communities Council. This is an organisation, you know, connected to people like David Campbell, Jonathan Powell, the former Chief of Staff of Tony Blair, and not to be engaging with organisations where there is an interest in our community, I think would be wrong, and it is right that Arlene did have that meeting. You know, we want all paramilitary organisations to leave, to disband, not to have their structures in place. That's why we and the executive support very much the paramilitary task force, and indeed the executive is seeking that funding to be extended for another 3 years in order to tackle these type of issues. You know, but I need to be very clear in terms of the approach that I have seen some take around this meeting, including the Alliance Party. It really is sanctimonious hypocrisy of the highest order coming from the Alliance Party. But there is also the transitioning of people that have been involved in these paramilitary organisations, which is part of the paramilitary task force. And I sit on the political advisory group, which is chaired by the Justice Minister, Naomi Long, and that is actively seeking to support people that are in paramilitary organisations to transition out of those organisations. And therefore, I really do despair at the language that has been deployed here, that somehow we are expected as a political party over the years to have shared government with a self-confessed IRA commander, the late Martin McGuinness, but dare us engage with people within the Loyalist community. You know, this is double standards of a breathtaking order.
Got to break in. We're nearly at the news. Paul Givan.
Well, listen, we will continue to engage with everyone that wants to make our country a better place. But I really do call on the Justice Minister to behave in a much more responsible way. But I look forward to her consistent approach now over the segregated regime at the prison for terrorist prisoners, that'll be gone. And that'll be a test of whether or not she's actually up for the challenge of dealing with terrorist organisations.